I'm Jen. I want to talk to you today just briefly about my new book, and it's called Truly Tan Freaked, and I just happen to have a copy handy. There it is. Isn't that gorgeous? And that is illustrated by Claire Robertson, so I'd like to thank her very much for this. It's a beautiful cover, isn't it? And the spine is mauve. It's gorgeous. All right, okay. Truly Tan Freaked. What can I tell you about this story? It's a little bit longer than the other three tan books. That's the first thing. It's 45,000 words long. And authors always speak in terms of words, not pages. So if you compare it to the other books come in at around 30,000 words. So this one's about 15,000 words longer. And why, Jen, did you write such a long book, you may well ask. And the reason is that I have so many letters and emails and kids who come up to me at signings and things and say that they read the latest tan in 2 days or 3 days. And I think, oh gosh, it doesn't seem to keep them entertained for very long. So I decided to make this one a little bit longer. And from now on, they're going to be longer. The other thing that I want to say is that this book was going to be the final book in the series. I only ever set out to write 4 books in this series. But halfway through writing this book, I was lucky enough to be invited to write another 4. So the series has kind of grown to an 8-book series. And who knows, I might write some more later on as well. So it may just be an ever-expanding sort of a series. But right now, we're looking at 8 books. So what else can we say about Freaked? Those of you who really enjoyed the 3rd book, Truly Tan Spooked, one of the things that I hear a lot from kids about Spooked was that they loved Molly, dear sweet Molly. Molly is Tan's best friend who comes from the city, and she comes to stay with Tan for a month because her mum is going to New York. So she goes to Peppercorn Valley for a whole month, which means she gets to go to school with Tan, she gets to go on the bus, and of course she is a secret spy just like Tan. So at the close of Spooked, Molly is still there. But of course, she does have to go home. She does have a home to go to. So in Freaked, we have to say goodbye to Molly. But it's a lovely farewell, and it's quite a long, drawn-out farewell scene. So don't think that you're going to miss out on, you know, on seeing Molly for quite some time before she goes. And it's a good excuse for a party. So Truly Tan Freaked opens with a really lovely party scene. And partly that was due to the fact that, again, I had some readers come up to me and say, Jen, do you think you could put a party in the next Tan book? And I thought, could I? I love a party. And so I love writing about parties. So it was great. It was really good fun. So I think it's a beautiful place to open a book is with a party scene. Of course, you don't have to have read Spooked to enjoy Freaked. None of the Tan books are actually in a sequence. They're all what's called standalone books. But it is nice to read them and watch Tan and her friends evolve over a little bit of time. So that's Truly Tan Freaked. There was one more thing I wanted to say. There's the paranormal side of this. You know how Tan is really, really into ghosts and spooks and whatnot. Well, I think, personally, that a lot of the ghosts are in her mind. I think it's, you know, her imagination is very rich, and I think a lot of these ghosts are not real. However, in Truly Tan Freaked, there is a ghost, and it is a real ghost. And so that makes Truly Tan Freaked a little bit more spooky and a little bit more fun. And the mystery is quite a bit more complicated than any other books. So Tan and Gloria are really, really tested in this one. They really have to get their thinking caps on to solve this mystery. I think that's about all I'm going to tell you for now. And I'll just show you the cover one more time, Truly Tan Freaked. And don't forget that this one has a map in it as well. So I love a book with a map, don't you? So you'll be able to see more clearly where tan lives and understand a little bit more clearly for those of you who are from the city and haven't lived in the country before, just what it's like for Tan, where she lives, way out whoop whoop on a property. And she has to catch a bus to school. There's no neighbours. There's no milk bar. There's no traffic lights. And in this one, look, there's somebody else. Somebody else is joining the menagerie. But I won't tell you any more about that. All right, Truly Tan Freaked, out now, October 2014, from HarperCollins Publishers. I hope you love it as much as I do. Okay, bye for now. Bye.